You know, we cover a lot of downer stories on this channel. Stories that just bring us down, for lack of a better word. And I'm sure they bring you guys down too. But today is not one of those days. Today is a day where we cover this insane convergence of events that led the lead singer of Pink Floyd to go after the Young Turks. And if that sounds amazing to you now, trust me, it's even more amazing than you can possibly imagine. This piece of content that we're going to go over today is gold. Speaking of which, diversifying your investments is like building a sports team. Each asset plays different roles. You have offensive players, assets that make gains and pay dividends, but equally as important is your defensive line, assets that will protect the value of your investment. There's a 5,000-year-old asset that has seen off every world crisis and thrived, gold and precious metals. The oldest hedge against inflation and disaster. Put it in your IRA. You can even defer taxes on all your gains until after you retire. That's compound growth on everything. You'd have stability and peace of mind that you made the right choice. Take out an IRA with Noble Gold this month, and along with first-class service, they will gift you a 1/10 of an ounce gold bullion American Eagle coin. To find out more, go to noblegoldinvestments.com or call them at 877-646-5347. Again, that's noblegoldinvestments.com or call them at 877-646-5347. Now, there's a lot of focus on this Twitter clip that we are going to get to in just a little bit of time because it is absolutely amazing. But you know me, I do my work, I do my research, and I bring you the stories from start to finish. I don't just harp on the major details. So I'd like to go back to the origin point of this story. And this is, of course, because the origin point of this story is a clip posted on the internet by one Stephen Michael Davis, a channel that is often recommended on this channel because he does things like this. Stephen found a clip from a post-game show, because he's a member of the Young Turks, where Anna Kasparian was less than kind to a journalist who was covering something really serious with Syria that, honestly, I don't want to get into. Here's the clip in question.
They said Aaron Mate yelled at me.
And so everyone cares what Aaron Mate has to say, right? Okay. The guy who denies that Syrian children were killed with chemical attacks. Yeah.
And fuck gets Aaron paid Mate. By the...
Yeah, fuck you. Anyway, let's move on. Russians. Let's end the freaking pod. I can't.
Okay, see, that's what happened.
I can't stand that guy, and I can't stand the very intentional disinformation they put out there in regard to disgusting dictators around the world. The very people they seem to be working for, to be quite honest with you. Let's move on.
All right, we're done.
Disgusting. Absolutely disgusting.
But now we know for sure.
So already, on its own, A-plus work from Stephen Michael Davis. This clip has all of the essentials of a bad Young Turks clip wrapped into one, including Anna Kasparian swearing, which is saved for the after show, but censored on YouTube during their main show because of their, you know, YouTube rules and all that jazz. So we get Anna in her full Anna mode, where she's really angry, she's screaming at the camera, and she's acting completely immaturely. And by the way, totally uncensored on this channel for this video, because we found a sponsor. So if we get demonetized, it's not that big of a deal. Support the sponsors, you support me, you get uncensored clips. But also, it has the Young Turks conspiracy mongering, because remember, what Anna was angry about at the beginning of this clip was allegedly the journalists reporting falsehoods and rumors and doing propaganda and spreading misinformation.
See, that's what happened.
I can't stand that guy, and I can't stand the very intentional disinformation they put out there in regard to disgusting dictators around the world.
But what is Cenk and Anna saying about this journalist who they don't like because he criticized Cenk's terrible tweet in relation to the Israel-Palestinian thing?
The very intentional disinformation they put out there in regard to disgusting dictators around the world. The very people they seem to be working for, to be quite honest with you. Let's move on.
All right, we're done.
Disgusting. Absolutely disgusting.
But now we know for sure
that he's being paid by the Russian government, so we have some Russia derangement syndrome in there. And then Anna goes even vaguer and says that he might be being paid by some unknown dictators. Obviously, she's referring to Bashar al-Assad of Syria, but these rumors are completely unfounded, not supported by anything. So in a segment where Anna Kasparian is so angry, she starts screaming at the camera like the immature person that she actually is, She's accusing somebody of spreading misinformation while she herself is just throwing out unverified rumors on their rinky-dink show. Now, already, this was going to make my YouTube channel because it's a great story on its own. Epic TYT fail, courtesy of Stephen Michael Davis, who was smart enough to watermark this footage with his logo, so you can see as multiple different progressive outlets that are going after TYT are using the same source clip from him. It appeared on Jimmy Dore, it appeared on this Twitter account, it went all over the place, and it was absolutely amazing. You have the journalist attacking Cenk, you have Cenk attacking back, Jimmy Dore's whole 50 plus minute segment on this. All great stuff, all first class all the way, all due to Stephen Michael Davis. But then it just got a little bit better. Then it just got a little bit more beautiful when the lead singer of Pink Floyd, a band that predates me by decades, decided that he was going to chime in from the ultra far left against the Young Turks. And we're going to go over this clip because it's absolutely hilarious in every way. I have to pause it because those are the rules of fair use. I have to give you the play-by-play commentary. But honestly, I will link this in the description. You will not be sorry if you watch this clip in full. It's fantastic.
Wow. Yeah.
What, do you want to comment?
Yeah, of course, sure.
What
yeah.
a fucking stupid fat prick. As just as long as they're throwing the F word around.
What an opening salvo. I mean, honestly, you can't possibly beat the scenario that we're in. We've actually transitioned to the absolute best timeline when a rock and roll legend is going after Cenk's weight live on the internet for the world to see based on something that Stephen Michael Davis posted. Honestly, I just gotta let the clip play because he starts going in on Anna, and you need to hear all this in its beautiful, uncensored glory.
I mean, and that woman, I haven't the faintest idea who she is, but she obviously can't read or write.
First of all, again, I just have to reiterate how much I love this. Never heard of Anna Kasparian ever in his life. Looks at her on this Young Turks clip and immediately deduces, and probably accurately, that Anna Kasparian is incapable of reading or writing. The lead singer of Pink Floyd thinks Anna Kasparian of the Young Turks is illiterate, and I'm here for it. It's amazing in every way. I am at a loss for words. Let me let the rock and roll legend himself take it away.
And the huge story that lies behind that, that has been completely ignored by the mainstream media because it's inconvenient. And when you actually look at the work that Aaron Marte, for a start, but Grey Zone in general do, in trying to bring us, we the people, the truth about what's actually going on in our world.
Look, so obviously this is an attack from the far left, so it's going to have a lot of lefty riffraff and whatever words. Roger Waters is a huge left-winger. He's attacking the Young Turks for not being left-wing enough in this case. I understand that. I don't want to go into the particulars of whether or not the chemical weapons attack was done by the Syrian government. Honestly, I can acknowledge that I'm not informed on the subject matter, and I didn't want to do the research for this because who cares? This is amazing. Let's get back into the clip.
To listen to that garbage and disgusting and foul-mouthed, I have to say, that young lady, well.
Okay. So real talk, I'm not adding in the clips in post-production. This clip is so good that even though I've seen it multiple times, I'm reacting live, watching it on my phone, and having a fantastic time. So I'm just gonna leave them in on the edits so you can enjoy it the way that I'm enjoying it. But this guy was able, without knowing who Anna Kasparian is at all, to diagnose her perfectly. She is incredibly foul-mouthed and incredibly vulgar and totally unqualified to cover the subject matter that she's talking about.
I hesitate to call her a young lady because she's clearly not in the prime of youth, but that's neither here nor there.
Whoa, Roger. I know you're a rock and roll legend, but you're completely out of bounds bringing this up in this scenario. It's not neither here nor there. That's amateur talk. It's neither nah nor nah, obviously. Also, denounce and reject any comments about the woman's age. How dare you? I am outraged. This is the one part that I do not condone at all in any way, shape, or form. We need to be better. We need to do better.
But the fact is, how dare she pontificate on some tin pot fucking show like the Fabulous Young Turks or whatever they call themselves? Well, who the fuck are they?
I agree with the rock and roll legend that's going after Anna Kasparian, Jen Kuger, and the Young Turks. How dare she? How dare she do this on the show called the Young Turks or whatever it's called? I mean, honestly, who are these people? How are they qualified? Who gave them a show? What's going on here?
I mean, to claim that she knows that Bashar Assad made a chemical attack to kill his own children or the children of his people is beyond condemnable. Is that a word?
I'm going to have to vote no, that is not a word, condemnable. But again, what do I know? This guy's a rock and roll legend, a lyricist, a lead singer, the absolute peak of his profession, and he is diagnosing the Young Turks absolutely perfectly. Anna Kasparian has barely, for her job, ever left California. So why is she going after a guy that actually specializes in the coverage of these stories?
I shouldn't really be expending any breath on it because it's so pitiful and pathetic.
Roger's really touching on something here, and I believe it really does speak to all of us out there who are observing TYT and have asked the question, who are these people, thousands of times.
I am not going to waste my borrow on whatever the young fucks are, because that was disgusting.
Oh my God. This is actually happening. Commentary, words and sentences. Something, something to break up the amazing leveling of the Young Turks by, again, an all-time great rock star. Amazing in every way. Next part of the clip.
Yeah.
And I've heard bad things about them for a long time.
You know, there's an old expression that basically goes like this: believe half of what you see and none of what you hear. But the often left off part about that is, unless you're hearing something bad about the Young Turks, then that's 100% true.
But they purport to be thinking young people who have an alternative. Yeah. They're not.
Again, not sure if this is a weird horseshoe moment or not, but I find myself being a libertarian on the right in full agreement with this left wing, far left, too far left for the Young Turks, in his dislike of the Young Turks and his assessment that TYT, not full of thinking people. Not sure what's happening. Maybe somebody needs to redraw the horseshoe and put anti-TYT at both ends of the horseshoe and we can unify the country. But until then, I'm just gonna go with it. On his side, don't even care what he's talking about. Absolutely elegant assessment of the situation.
Obviously, they're great supporters of regime change in Syria.
Look, all joking aside about how funny this whole scenario and this clip actually are, this is something that he's actually pretty accurate about. The Young Turks do support regime change in Syria. I know that Cenk Uygur in the past was pro the no-fly zone in Libya, and then he kind of backed away from it after the fact, sort of. But this is a perfect example of the Young Turks, who act like they're an anti-war organization, actually showing force and being pro-war. If it's Iran, then they're against it. If it's Iraq, then they're against it. But there are certain things that Cenk Uygur has historically been supportive of, and intervention in Syria is something that the network has basically taken a position on. So of all the things that are in here, I actually 100% agree with this on the merits that this is the Young Turks' position. So I understand why this is driving a wedge between the more anti-war left and the Young Turks. Now, I don't have much more to add in terms of this video. I want to just, again, shout out Stephen Michael Davis for finding this clip, posting it on the internet, and it leading to a chain of events that brought us here, where a rock and roll legend is going after Cenk and Anna on some weird, like, StreamYard show. How is this even happening? I don't even care. It's amazing. But let me know what you guys think down in the comments below. Are you just as overjoyed with this turn of events or not? If you like the video, you know what to do. Subscribe for more content. Follow me on all my social medias. They're linked in the description. Support the sponsor. Links in the description and in the pinned comment. Till next time.